Ambassador Akram, let me go to you, and you may also want to respond to this question of how we re-energize our dedication to the SDGs and the Decade of Action.
Thank you. I think with regard to the SDGs, as the Secretary General has made clear, first of all, unless we are able to deal with this pandemic and able to conquer it in the shortest possible time, we will be off track on the SDGs, and seriously off track, because the world is now diverging even more seriously. The richer countries are recovering, and the poorer countries are going down. So if we are going to achieve the SDGs, we have to conquer this pandemic, and we need to express the solidarity in order to conquer this pandemic. I think that's the simplest answer I could give. But I would also like to respond to what the distinguished colleague from the United States talked about, of how to preserve the international order. And I think we all recognize that the order of the last 75 years has been based on the principles of the UN Charter. There's a lot of talk about rules-based societies and rule-based order, but all the rules emerge from the principles of the Charter. And we have built a whole international system of law and the practice of justice on the basis of the principles of the Charter. I think if we are going to promote peace and address the issues, the conflicts that are all over the world, whether these are economic, political, human rights issues, all of these must be dealt with on the basis of the laws, of the Charter and the laws that we have built together. But there is a big but. We must apply those laws and principles consistently and with equity to all, to the big and the small, to the powerful and the weak. There must be only one system of justice. And unless we are able to prove that the weak can aspire to the same justice as the strong, we will not have a world order which is based on justice. We will have a world order as it is today, based on strength and power.
Thank you, Ambassador.